become involved in the Bring Back Our Girls campaign? And what was most moving for you just a couple weeks ago when you went to Kenya and Nigeria meeting with young girls like yourself?
What is interesting is the power and the impact of social media, and as well as like the TV channels and the other media, which is now called the other media. On social media, you know about these issues that people are suffering and they highlight it. So it's very important that we try to use social media in a good way. And it was good because Bring Back Our Girls was a campaign on social media and people highlighted it. And that's why I just came to know about it in April. I did not like see it because I was in the UK. It was happening in Nigeria, but it was media, it was TV channels, newspapers, Twitter, Facebook, etc., on which I saw that people were speaking about more than 200 girls being abducted by Boko Haram and they wanted them to return to their homes safely. That's how I came to know about it. Other than that, there were some other issues as well. For example, in Kenya, there are girls who are out of school, but the main difficulty for both girls and boys in Kenya and Nigeria is that they do not get free education after the primary level. So if they do their primary level and when they reach to their secondary level in their education, they don't have money, they can't get education. So that's the basic reason that is stopping children from going to school. And in Kenya, I met wonderful girls. They were amazing. And I asked them about their education, about their dreams, and most of them just wanted to be doctors, teachers, engineers. They wanted to help their community, to help their society, and some of them are lucky who get this opportunity to go to the secondary school, because only 1 out of 10 girls get this opportunity to reach the secondary level. So there are only a few girls who could go there, and we wanted to see the work of Free the Children, which is a great organization and is working for education in Kenya. And we also did a project with them of building school. So I went to their school and I saw so many girls. They were wonderful. They were so intelligent as well. They were studying like science and chemistry and all these things. And I was with them sitting in their classroom. There was a teacher and I behaved like a normal student. And it was a wonderful time just to be in a school and to listen to the girls, what they say, and to know about their dreams and to know that they still have hope. Because, and when I went to Kenya, I also realized what changes education has brought into that community, because I always talk that education can bring change and education can really change our society. But I really saw it in Kenya. I went and I asked one of the Maasai warrior that how can you become a Maasai warrior? And he said that before we saw education and in our community schools were built, the boy who used to kill more than one lion and do some other acts of bravery, and his two teeth would be pulled out. And if the person cried, then he won't become the warrior. But if the person doesn't cry, then he would become the warrior. So it was quite a difficult job to become a warrior. I won't do that. But then he said that it was long ago. Now we have changed that idea. So if a girl and a boy completes his or her education and gets a degree, go to university, finishes education, then that person becomes a warrior. So now, girl who has completed her education is a Maasai warrior. A boy who has completed his education is a Maasai warrior. So this is the change that education has brought into their community, and they have also stopped female genital mutilation because now they are aware of the side effects of it on girls' health and their lives. So I really saw that, yes, which the changes which I always dream of and which I want to come into our society have already come, and these changes have been brought by education. So I was so hopeful when I was in Kenya, and for 2-3 days I was just thinking like, oh, we can change this whole world and everything would be fine in just 2-3 days, just build schools.